Well, first of all, thank you for the invitation. It has been a fantastic opportunity. I came to talk to the conference with the eyes, basically, of the practitioner. I mean, we are finding here people that are very much into the development of the standards themselves, but we also have to consider the views and the standpoints from the practitioner. That is my case. So one of the main takeaways from the presentation is how to try to integrate the ISO 31000 in particular, risk management in general, within ISO 9001, and in my case in particular within the certifications that we run over there. It is certainly not easy. The second takeaway that I also introduce in the discussion is if you go to the standard, to the 9001, you will see that the reference to 31000, that I know is not a standard, a principle and guidance, is simply in the bibliography, is the word in English, is simply not a normative reference at the time for the practitioners to work. And my question to the audience is, why are we moving in that direction? If we have a standard that is coordinated with the international community, that is traversing through a number of certification, and why shouldn't we use it? I was mentioning that, for instance, in the domain I'm working in NATO, we do exactly the opposite. So the documents that we have, we say use 31000 unless you have a better option, unless you have a justification. And the third one, I was introducing an example of what we are trying to do in our organization regarding a risk management framework, the process that we are planning to implement at different functional areas. And I also pointing out that I was following the 31000 basically from cradle to grave with the necessary training and the tailoring that we have to have for our specific circumstances there. So I think those are the three main takeaways from the presentations. I think there is a key factor here, especially in times where budgets are absolutely constrained, where the managers, in my case, the commanders are very much focused on operations and the success of the operations. I think the key factor is that what we are doing is basically adding value to the organization. You have to be able to prove that that is the case. So you have a number of mechanisms, obviously, that you have to use, but yeah, I think that is the main core value that we have. You have to add value to the organization. Young people, first of all, it's not an easy profession. If you're planning to have friends, don't come to the quality and risk management domain, you will have many enemies. No, I'm joking. No, I think we were also talking during the sessions here about competence. You have to be a competent professional. I mean, if you want to do this professionally, you have to be a competent person. So training and developing the skills is absolutely fundamental. And whenever, hopefully, you get access to the profession, you have to make sure and you have to attest yourself in order to get the resources and the authority that such a position requires. At the end of the day, you have to go to commanders, you have to go to managers, and you have to sometimes tell them that what they are doing is not the right things. So you need, I insist, the authority, the skills, and the resources. That would be my advice to the new generations.